All right, we're live here in the studios with Michael Nesmith. Hi, Michael. How are you doing?
How are you, John?
I'm doing great, and you're doing great, too.
Well, you know what? I had this health thing, which just knocked me down.
That
what was
seems
it, three weeks
happen,
ago
it?
Or 4 weeks? Oh, man. That was a wake-up call. So,
was it a surprise? Did you know you were having problems, or did it all of a sudden it just come up?
Probably more the latter than the former, but it was a mixture of both. You know, I'd just been kind of plugging along and thinking, gosh, it's hard to breathe, and it hurts when I breathe, and so forth. And then the cardiologist, the guy says, oh, you're in real danger of dying. You should probably come see us. So
I went, a little hint.
Yeah. So I went there, up to Chomp, got a team of cardiologists. They pick you up, shake you like a rag doll, pour everything out on the table, and then put it back.
Oh,
so,
God.
Boy, that was really quite a journey.
Yikes.
And this just happened recently.
Yeah, 4 weeks ago.
And you're up and moving and looking fine?
And everybody tells me who's been through it, or knows somebody who's been through it, they say this is complete rejuvenation. You come out of this, and once it all self-stitches back together, you just feel like a new man. So I just can't wait. I don't feel like a new man now.
I'm not real fond of the old ones.
Yeah. So. But it was right in the middle of a tour that I was doing with Mick.
Yeah. From, was it the Monkees thing, or what were you guys doing? You didn't come here.
No. Well, Mickey and I have talked about doing a duo show for years. Mike and Mickey.
Yeah.
And never had the clear span to do it. There was either some other promoter or one of us would be going out by ourselves. And so when it looked like we had the room to do a duet, we put together the duet, and that was the show that we took out. And it was, I mean, myself, it was wonderful, just wonderful. It was great. First of all, it's great working with Mick.
Yeah.
He's a real pro. And great working with the band. And, you know, we get to sing a catalog of hits that sold 100 million records. I mean, it's just, you don't get to take that firepower on stage too often. And they were great. You know, it was a good time. But right in the middle of the whole damn show, and there, boom! I fell over. So.
Oh, what, really?
Yeah. We had a bunch of dates we had to actually still go do after the first of the year that we couldn't do.
Just couldn't finish up the show. So that show, John Stewart is gone. Not the comedian John Stewart, but the singer John Stewart, who
yep.
got one of the hugest ka-chings in his life
yeah.
from the Monkey Show.
That's exactly right. And Michael Martin Murphy came to visit me in Arizona somewhere, and showed up, and he just walked up to me silently, gave me a 30-second hug, and walked away.
Well, I'm sure those guys are so appreciative
yeah.
of what happened.
That changed
but
your life.
Now new things are happening, and there's a brand new vinyl and CD. The
yeah.
vinyl is beautiful. I'm holding.
Well, that's
in the
that
hand.
English, you know, craftsmanship. I mean, that. Did you see the vinyl record itself?
No, I hear it. No, I haven't opened
it.
It's
heavyweight.
I can feel that. Yeah.
Yeah, it's got that whatever that vinyl is that they put in it that makes it have fidelity like the old vinyls used to.
Yeah.
I don't actually, you know, to be completely candid, I don't see what the fuss is about vinyl. I grew up on vinyl, you know.
It's nostalgia. Yeah. Well, it's nostalgia.
And I still have all that gear, so that all worked pretty good.
Yeah. And all the new acts. I mean, this fellow that who was just here, he just put this out. So a lot of the new acts want to have a vinyl. It's just such
yeah.
a big part of our musical history that we've all had stacked in corners or on shows in our homes.
Well, this is an English company called 7A. They're not, you know, tiny. They're big enough to get done what they need to get done. But I, they said, well, we want to put this out in vinyl. And I said, vinyl, that's just
over. The new thing.
Yeah. Well, the new thing, right. But I was thinking it was maybe being made out to be more than it was. I still kind of think that. I don't.
But look at the photography and all of that part. You know?
Yeah, well, that part of it, you know, the 12-inch format is just undeniably beautiful.
Absolutely. Well, this is a gorgeous album. And is it a live recording from the shows?
It is.
So, as those of you who were lucky enough to be at Michael's show with the First National Band, this was at the Troubador, down at the Troubador in L.A. Mm-hmm. But they played here at the Rio Theater for a wonderful show about 4 or 5 months ago, it seems.
Oh, has it been that recent? I can't remember.
I can't remember exactly, but I came and just really enjoyed it. So,
January,
that's when it was. Should we start off with that first cut and take a listen
please,
to it?
Yeah.
Okay, Beck, you want to play that
sure,
for us?
Sure, let's do it.
We're not hearing in the room. It's going over the airways.
It's going over the air. I had a mic though.
So did you work on the album itself, or did you just send them the tapes, or how did that all go?
You mean the post-production kind of?
Yeah.
No, my son, Christian, did all of it. You know, once it was clear that he was as competent as he is, he's got a great set of ears, I just turned it over to him. And I think he's done a fantastic job. It really does sound like us a lot.
And when is it coming in? Is it out?
It's out now. 7A has got it out in England and over the UK somewhere.
Since Okay, let's go back. We're live and on the air with Michael Nesmith there, and we just heard the first cut off of that, Nevada Fighter, and some of my favorite, Rio. Oh, man, I love that. That song. What has been your biggest requested song, you know, when you know something you have to play when you go to do shows?
As my number two son says, you can't not play songs. Well, you know, I've got this dual channel career going, one of which is Mike of the Monkees, and the other which is Michael Nesmith of these later works. In the later works, they are actually more widely accepted and recognized than the earlier stuff from the Monkees. I didn't have a whole lot to do with that, but still in all, you know, I'm heavily associated with it, which I like. But the playing these songs, I find that kind of my number one requested song is Rio. That was a number one record in Australia.
Is that right?
Yeah, so I'm not sure what that means, except I got invited back.
Well, that's good enough.
Yeah, that was something. And
Rio, because it's one of my favorite songs of yours ever. And I'm glad to hear I'm not standing alone here. Yeah, it's such a wonderful tune.
And this band really plays a hell of a version of it. I mean, it's just...
Yeah, I heard that.
It's sensational.
Are we playing, is that part of our playlist today?
Nope. No.
Maybe we'll play that in the next time. So, also you have, which I guess is the first thing, different drummers, the song that I'm thinking of.
Yeah.
And Linda did such an incredible job with that.
Had a huge hit with it. Yeah.
Was that your first hit?
Well, it was a surprise, so... I don't know whether the first time is a surprise is general, but it that was, I had never had anything like that happen, so it was just, you know, in the Monkees thing I had, there was plenty of creative return and fun to be had on stage playing and stuff, but just in terms of writing a song and putting it out there and having a thing take over the airwaves.
Boy, didn't it?
It was, that was the first time for me, and so it was very exciting. And
those were in the Topanga Canyon years, too.
They were, yeah. That's right. Linda lived up in Beechwood Canyon, and Bill Martin, and the whole kind of nexus of the Eagles, and Jackson, and those guys. They were all in the same area.
Yeah.
And different drum. Came into their purview by way of John Harold, who was, he's no longer with us, but he was the leader of the Greenbrier Boys.
Oh,
out of New York.
Yes.
And he is the one who basically slowed it down and made it a ballad that Linda could sing. I credit him with the fact that it became as big as it did, because I was doing it country twang.
Yeah.
You know, a big dose of accent and a big dose of goddamn how are you.
So he did you give it to her, or did he give it, how did she get it?
She got it from John.
Yeah,
she was you know, she was an aficionado, and she really, every time that there was a Topanga Canyon gathering, or we were all down in the river someplace, but she'd be there. And she was trying to teach herself fiddle. I don't know whether she ever did or not.
I've never heard of that.
I don't think you've ever heard of it. And so she was part of that group of people that we'd get together on the weekends.
What a group.
Yeah.
What a group.
Well, guys coming in from New York, you know, really. Aces player. Some few guys from Nashville. And it was wonderful music in the afternoon.
The days of the L.A. music mafia.
Yeah.
So let's play another tune off of this. What's the next one we got, Vic?
Papa Jean's Blues.
Oh yeah, this was a Monkees hit.
Oh, okay.
I mean, not this song necessarily. This is just the first national band doing it as we do it. And so.
Okay.
It
this is all done with the Troubador.
Oh,
thanks.
Yeah.
And what a
no heartaches felt no longer lonely. Nights of waiting finally won me. Happiness is all rolled up in you. And now with you as inspiration, I look toward a destination. Sunny bright that once before was blue.
So he had
helped out. I have no more than I did before.
I love it when the crowd starts singing.
I love you and I know
you. Never knew what it was called.
So take my hand, I'll start a journey. Free from all the helpless worry. That is a hell of
what was he doing?
War strength is
mine. No person really
and
flagship.
I know I'll never
ever pass the highest
rank for the love. I have no more than I did before. Now I've got all that I
need. We were going down to good times to be had at the Troubador.
They didn't like this one, huh?
No.
Okay. Was that? Who was that laughing there, right? Is that you laughing at the end?
Yeah.
That was what a great, great live recording of it. So this was all recorded at the Troubador.
It is.
In one night?
I don't know. Ed Heffelfinger did it.
All in one night.
All in one night. Amazing one night. To get all of this in one night. This is a beautiful double vinyl album and a double CD, I would assume, also.
Yeah.
And it's all recorded at the Troubador, and it is available now in the United States.
Yes, you can buy it from Video Ranch.
Can you?
Video Ranch, yeah.
And how do you reach Video Ranch?
Well,
Video Ranch, Dad?
VideoRanch3D.com.
VideoRanch3D.com. Okay, so you got that? VideoRanch3D.com. If you want to pick up a copy of this, you can do that.
Autographed.
Autographed. Ooh.
They're on
back
order right now.
By me.
There has been occasions. Yeah. An autographed album, not by the person who made it.
One
so,
way around.
Anyway, I'd like to go back a little bit again, and maybe you're going to do something like this still, and the studio is still open, Video Ranch down in West End, and Elephant Parts. That you sort of started the music video. I mean, they were doing music videos back with Cab Calloway and them, but you really brought it into the modern thing. Aren't you sort of the father of that? I mean, I hate to put that question to you.
Well, so they say. No,
yeah.
So, I appreciate it. It just sort of fell into my lap. I didn't set off on a mission to come up with a music video. So I just... And the more I worked on it with my friends, all of whom were talented filmmakers, it just kind of fell in our laps. And we were looking one day at this, so this is really novel, and it's good, and it's interesting, and we have a good time to, we have a good time to make it mean something.
Yeah.
So that's when we rolled it out there, and sure enough, it got a lot of traction.
Well, the one that with the roller skaters, now the name is
Cruising.
Yes, what a wonderful, what a wonderful piece of work.
Yeah.
And did you film that all in Hollywood Boulevard?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I mean, it looked like it, but you never know.
We were that filmmaking crew.
That was what a wonderful thing.
Yeah.
So you're going to tour behind this?
Yes.
And when does that start? Or have you even decided?
In a couple of weeks is the due date to trigger it and go. But
yeah.
I don't, at this point, I haven't fully committed to the promoters and so forth to do it because I'm still recovering from this last hit.
Man, a rather big one.
Yeah,
rather
not big hit, one. Yeah, not hit in the
in the positive way.
Yeah, no, but hit in the car wreck way.
Yeah,
and so that's taken a little bit of time. I'm walking slow and thinking and practicing my singing. When I sing now, it sounds like a warble. They took everything out and put it all back. You know, took everything and ran it through the washer dryer and put it back in.
But so you don't even know what you're going to sound like.
No,
now.
I mean, I know I sound like, oh, like that.
Well,
who knows what that is, how useful it is. What do you think of it, Diego?
Diego likes it.
I like it.
All right, let's...
We should take a break.
Oh, we should take a break? Okay, come back. We'll play the last cut and talk a little bit more.
Have you stayed at this post here for a while?
I have been here since the very beginning. I'm the last of the original KPIG people.
That's amazing.
Yeah, 35 years.
We can't get rid of them.
No?
Yeah, they've tried. No, I... Lori Ellen hired me to be their merch guy. To sell the t-shirts and all that stuff. So we had this big meeting and they assigned all of the DJs their spots. The DJs all of their spots. And of course I didn't have one, although I was working as a DJ in Kazoo, when it was a music station. And so I said, well, you don't have a midnight version. Let me do midnight to 2. Begrudgingly, she said, oh, okay, I don't care. Go ahead. So I did it 2 nights. And then the weekend came, and one of the guys on the weekend smoked a joint out on the porch. And the landlord saw it and freaked out and fired him and said, we can't have that guy around here. You have to get rid of the joint. I'm taking you. And so I was, they said, okay, now you can be Saturday afternoons. And so I started doing Saturdays, and then the midday person quit, and I got midday and stayed there for decades. And finally I got to the point where enough of coming in 5 days a week, and I've been doing this also. This is like our 1130th live music show.
In 2017,
I got to be on the air because everyone wanted to go to Hartley Strictly. All right,
that's it. We all had so much training.
Yeah, I know.
But it's it really made a change my life.
What I was trying to say was Rio is on the vinyl album. You got it. You read my song, but not on the CD.
And we have the song in the tape. We have the studio.
And never thought, and I took off when I turned 50, I took a year and took the dog I had at the time, and we took a year's trip to Mexico and Central America. I think that should be a requirement that everybody gets a year off when they turn 50 to do
Trip with the dog.
Travel with Charlie. That's what inspired me.
Sure.
Oh, 6 minutes.
Yeah. Yeah, is it still 6 p.m.?
Yeah, because
we have 2 6-minute commercial breaks during the live show, so each ad cast.
I don't know why they do it at the end.
Well, because we do one at 11:30, one at 12, one at 10:30, 11.
4 minutes, 11:50. Because I thought 6 minutes was time to set up.
They want 12. Well, they want 12 commercials an hour.
Oh, 12. Yeah, right.
So 2 6 instead of 3 4s.
Right. Gotcha.
So we'll do another, play another cut off this, talk for a few more minutes, and.
Yeah, this is a 6-minute cut. Grand Annuie. That's the one you want, right?
Grand Annuie.
Oh, so any TV? You going to do any TV with this?
Well, no, nobody's asking me, so I'm just going to kind of leave that alone.
Yeah,
but I am going to go out live if that comes together. And that has a big effect. The live show of this is sui generis. I mean, it's a unique show. And it's completely
And these
unexpected.
Two, boy, they're good.
true. They still with you, too?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, there's a whole sort of corral thing. All the guys. There's six background voices.
Amazing. This, I was looking at this picture, and I know he doesn't really look like it, but it looks like John Prine.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, the current John Prine.
Oh, sure, yeah.
With the John Prine eyes. Well, I would think, you know, one of the late night shows or even Saturday Night Live, this would be a perfect experience for him.
Well, it just, you know, you just never know these days.
So do you have management that books you, or do you?
I do, except I've got so much of it in-house.
Yeah.
I just do myself, and people work for me, and it works out really good.
Who's your agent?
APA.
Oh, that's a nice one, too. They have some common connections. Well, if you ever want to come back to the Rio, I'd be happy to
do it. Sounds great.
And that's been a great boom for Santa Cruz. God, it's been so much great.
It's such a nice venue.
Yeah.
It really turned out to be a good idea.
Well, the guy that ran Lawrence Bedford just took all the money, put it back in the seats and the sound and everything.
Yeah,
really true.
Well, I remember when I played there thinking, boy, this is really fine venue.
It is. It's been great for the community. How are we doing?
30 seconds.
Okay. Boy, so many times in the Troubador when I was, before I was first getting into listening to music, I was there a lot. And the other one, the folk club in LA at the same time, I must have played there at some point. Quality and elegance with savings of 30%
to 50%
off classic legacy fine furniture today. 1228
South Main Street. Wasn't
Dave Alvin.
Wasn't McCabe.
No.
Wasn't the Emperor.
No.
KPIG
Freedom. What's that song? KPY. She'll know, but back to the...
Alrighty.
Hey, what was the song Dave Alvin wrote about the club in L.A.?
Ashgrove. So bad on the spot.
Yeah. We were talking, and I was trying to remember the name of the Ashgrove. So,
yeah.
Did you ever get to play in there when you were starting?
No, I never did.
Yeah,
I never did. Of course, it was a hang, but
I never
played.
All right. So, you're going on the road with this, and don't know when exactly or where you're going to go, but watch for it. We'll try and get it to come back here at some point, also into the Monterey Bay someplace. And so we're going to play, what's the tune we're going to close this with?
Grand Ennui.
And tell us about that song.
It was a standalone song. I didn't really have any place to put it. Couldn't put it in the Monkees. It was too off the Monkees style and so forth. And then I started playing it myself, which worked out pretty good. But it wasn't until I got this band together that I was really able to get Pedro out of it, so that you'll hear when you hear how it's played. It's a rouser. People just jump up and start clapping and dancing.
Well, they do that a lot when you play.
Do they?
You may notice that from the stage.
Well,
there's a lot of enthusiasm when you show up.
Yeah. Well, that's good to hear.
I wish you had noticed.
I would have too.
So are you guys all headed down to the West End celebration today?
No.
Give them a little ka-ching here. That
yeah, I don't know about that. I may do a drive-by wave.
Yeah, well, that's where you're headquartered with your,
yeah,
with your
studio. Yeah, just down the street from there.
All right. And the good news is Michael is still working in that studio and still putting together new ideas. You have come up with more innovations than you deserve. It's just really wonderful
well
what you've
said,
done for music, and I appreciate it, and I thank you for coming up here. And we're going to play this song, and you'll hear a lot more of this. This is definitely added to the KPIG playlists. And thank you so much for coming up and joining
us. It's great to see you, John.
Good
to see you looking so well.
You too.
Yeah.
You too.
Yeah.
All right, Vic, you want to start that up for us? And I'll see you guys after the song. The beginning. What was that guy that wrote all the cartoon music for Warner Brothers?
Yeah, I know.
Spike Jones?
What? No, but they put out a, you know, like a triple album of all of the soundtracks.
Yeah,
of
those.
with a dog like you.
Can I get a smile from you guys? Let me get a picture of you two.
Okay, let me slide over here.
Yeah. All right. Excellent. Here we go. One, two. One more. One, two, three. Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you. And thank you. I really appreciate you getting up and coming out here and spending the time with us.
I enjoyed it. Good to meet you. Good to see the bigs still here.
Still here.
Working.
You come by anytime.
Yeah, thank you.